Welcome back to the Sports Source, this segment brought to you by Southeast Termite and Pest Control, locally owned, family owned since 1971. That means every dollar they earn gets spent right back here in our community. Most companies that started local, the pest control companies around here, they've all sold to national groups. They've kept the name, but they're no longer local companies. But when you call Southeast Termite and Pest Control, it is so local, you can still talk to the owner himself. And unlike most pest control companies, you don't talk to salespeople, you talk to technicians. It's a different beast when you talk to Southeast Termite and Pest Control. That's why I use them, used them for years. You should too, southeasttermite.com. All right, well, let's welcome in the next two members of our panel in to talk basketball. We have former UT assistant coach Mark Pankratz right there. Former Vol Isaiah Victor right there. Gentlemen, thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Tennessee headed west yesterday, got the best of Colorado 69-54. And here's the thing, Colorado was 23-9 last year, NCAA tournament team. That's a good quality win on the road for the 13th ranked Vols. Isaiah, good win, but what stole the show was Kennedy Chandler. Your thoughts on how Tennessee's true freshman looked yesterday?
He looked really good. It was easily a breakout game for him. It was our first real road game, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, true, yeah.
So, you know, that could speak volumes for the way he could play on the road. You always wonder what a guy would do on the road. That's everybody. So he showed that. And he left the door open because he didn't shoot well from three. But he still had 29 points, finished strong, got to the basket a lot. I think other teams that are watching us play, watch that game, they're going to play the pick and roll different. Because he was able to get the pick high screen and get downhill for a lot of easy buckets, easy to him. But nevertheless, it was a big, big game for him.
Mark, your thoughts on the performance of Kennedy Chandler?
We talk about the points, but multiple dimensions. I mean, scoring at the rim, the floaters, the knocking down threes, but the understanding, the leadership of, you know, he gets the mismatches and ball screens and backs out the big and then attacks the big downhill. His defense, his deflections, he blocks a couple shots. It's so interesting. You see a coach like Barnes, Hall of Fame coach, who has not been a big ball screen type of guy as far as what he runs in his offense. And he's putting the keys, he's giving the keys to Chandler in the way that he's running these ball screens and spacing out. Staff has done a great job of moving Chandler around. But I agree, he likes to go right. We'll see how they adapt moving forward. But definitely a breakout game. Definitely enjoy it while you can, because he won't be here very long until he plays at that next level.
Yeah, to me it was one of those, Tennessee's had one and done guys. He had a couple last year. And they were good, great players. But this one was different. This Kennedy Chandler to me looks like a guy that typically you would say, oh, that's one of those Duke one and done guys. That's one of those Kentucky one and done guys where there's no debate that, yeah, it's a lottery pick, that's top five pick, that's gone next year. That's what he looked like yesterday. And then, for the most part, that's what he's looked like all year.
Against a good team.
Against a good team. Let's take a look at the box score. I'm just going to put this up there. You can kind of get out your magnifying glass and stare at that if you like. But I'm going to ask you, Josh and Vince, Vols didn't shoot well from beyond the arc, just 6 of 24. Dug themselves an 8-0 hole to start. I think that makes this win more impressive, that you go out to a quality opponent on the road, true road game, you take care of business and you win it relatively easily. I mean, granted, there was a point there midway through the second half where it got tight. But for the most part, you kind of coasted to a victory there against a good team when I don't think you played your 100% best game.
Yeah, I thought so too, because you could tell pretty early. Not going to really shoot well. And it played out that way the rest of the game from the outside. But that comes back to Kennedy Chandler, I think. His ability to make plays around the basket and set up other teammates. You know, if you don't have Kennedy Chandler, I don't know that you have that plan B to where, okay, we adjust this way, go attack and see if that can set up teammates to do something else within the offense. So it comes back to him. He's going to drive what they do. Games where they shoot really well, you're not going to stop Tennessee. But you're going to have games like that where you shoot 25% from three. Yeah. You need to have another option. Kennedy Chandler is that.
Vince?
Well, and he's a guy that they didn't have his type of fix-it type of offensive guy last year. And now they do. When things aren't working well, getting it into the shot clock, he can create. He threatens the defense in so many different ways. He opens things up for everybody. So it's a difference, completely different than last year. Plus, he brings you an energy, an emotion, a swagger that the other guys really didn't have last year. It took them a while to kind of settle in. Remember, they were probably the two best players at the end of last year for Tennessee. Well, he's coming in, and he's their best player and leading scorer right out of the gate. And so I think he just brings so many different dimensions that this team didn't have. Incredibly impressive. And another thing that was impressive about their win is every time Colorado would try to creep back in, Tennessee would have an answer, whether it was a ball screen or something else or Chandler. They always would have an answer and push Colorado back on the road. Very impressive.
Mark and Isaiah, your thoughts on Josiah Jordan-James? Had missed a few games with a torn ligament in a finger in his shooting hand. Got back in yesterday, got 20-plus minutes on the floor. What do you think about how he looked, and what do you think about playing with that kind of an injury on your shooting hand?
The way that he can rebound, the way that he can defend by being versatile and switching on the guys, that's his biggest attribute. I believe he knocked down a big three. I think Colorado cut it to five, and Josiah made a three to lead, put it back up to eight when they were making a run. But his leadership, his presence, is what keeps him on the floor. Because if not, you've got some other quality guards, and if Brandon Huntley Hatfield keeps developing, there's some pressure on Josiah to produce in the stats. But what keeps him out there right now is his leadership and his experience.
You didn't see anything then yesterday in his game that told you that concerned you as a coach with the bum finger?
No, I think he was out there and was able to play around it.
Barnes was raving about him in the post game. Yeah. Absolutely raving about him.
Isaiah, your thoughts on the difficulty of playing with something like that in your shooting hand? It seems to me like that would at least get in your head a little bit, and you'd have to adjust to it.
Definitely, it's psychological. But at the same time, I'm with him on the leadership part of it. You get out there and play if you can, and then because he's the guy that's telling the young guys, hey, we need to do this, we need to do that. Well, he's got to be an example, and I think he set a really good example yesterday by going out there and playing anyway. And he played some four yesterday. I really like how Coach Barnes mixing up the lineup, playing a smaller lineup with him, because he is so versatile, he can guard so many different sorts of players, and I think that helps us a lot.
Let's talk about some of the surprises we've seen from Rick Barnes. Saw some zone pop up when Villanova was lighting them up, but there's some things we haven't seen as much of in the past that we seem to be seeing now. Shooting threes constantly. It looks like Rick Barnes has made some adjustments this offseason. Let's talk about that, and let's talk about Tennessee's next five games, because it's a heck of a run. I love the schedule they put together, and the next five have some really good games in it. Let's talk about that next on the Sports Source.
And you better watch out, you better not cry, you better not bow, I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa